Good afternoon and welcome to the Old South Church. Thank you for joining Boston Children's Chorus for our Lord Chorus concert, Pray!
Today's concert will explore how we can be good friends, neighbors, and citizens, and how we can find the courage to love ourselves and use the strength to advocate for others, alongside our special guest artist, Melanie DeMore.
You can learn more about this afternoon's program, find full song lyrics, read bios for our Melanie DeMore, and more by scanning the QR code on the front of your program sheet or by visiting bostonchildrenschorus.org. We also welcome those who are joining us via livestream, and we invite you to find a link to our full program pinned at the top of the comments. Please make sure to silence all cell phones for the duration of the program. However, we do encourage photos and video recording during the concert. Please be sure to tag Boston Children's Chorus in your social posts. If you are the parent or caregiver of a singer immediately following the concert, please remain seated to allow other patrons to exit the building and give singers time to gather their belongings. The singer dismissal plan is available on the last page of the digital program book and can also be found by scanning the QR code on the front of your program sheet.
In case of emergency, please follow the sign to the nearest exits Follow the instructions from the ushers on the best way to leave safely.
And finally, as BCC's tradition, we invite you now to take a moment to introduce yourself to a neighbor and say hello. Thank you again for joining us, and we hope you enjoy this. Thank you again for joining us, and we hope you enjoy this afternoon performance of Brave. The concert will run approximately 1 hour with no intermission, and we'll begin in a few minutes.
Believing in yourself truly is the place to start. And why not on a wonderful day like today?
In a world where everyone's always fighting and not getting along, it feels you can't do anything to make things better. Author Jimmy Allen wrote, maybe you think your voice is too small, or that you're too young to show the world what you believe in. But actually, all voices can make change happen. From a voice as tall as a tree to a voice as small as a bee.
With courage and determination, even one small voice can be powerful.
Thank you. Everyone wants to be accepted and to feel like they belong in the world.
In our journey to find our own voice, we often face who other people think we should be. Youth activist Jazz Jennings reminds us that the world needs your unique story and voice. Even when your differences can feel like a curse, in being different, there is no right side or wrong. It's just who you are.
Be the best you that you can be. Tell your story with honesty, and you will shine ever brightly being who you are.
Sometimes it takes a good friend to lift us up and remind us of who we are.
We often become like the people we spend the most time with. As we build our communities, we look for friends who bring out the best in us. We look for people who help us lead us to the well, our own sense of creativity and hope, and those who tend the fires, people who show up and work to make our world better for all.
We shall be known.
others love themselves deeply and be loved by others, even amidst their own fear and pain, invites us to meet our emotions and journeys with compassion. Their courage helps us learn to better love ourselves.
This Is Me has become an anthem for boldly standing tall, feeling pride in who you are, and accepting your unique identity and journey, even with all of our pain and insecurities. At the climax of the original song, you hear the words, "I know that I deserve your love. There's nothing I'm not worthy of." These words remind us of the inherent value, dignity, and worth of all of us, for every human being across the earth.
Stranger to the dark, hide away, they say, 'cause we don't want your broken parts. I've learned to be ashamed of all my scars. Run away, they say, 'cause no one will love you as you are. But I won't let them break me down to dust. I know that there's a place for us, for we are glorious.
Those words won't cut me down. Gonna send a flood, gonna drown them out. I am brave, I am bruised, I am who I'm meant to be. This is me. Look out, 'cause here I come. And I'm marching on to the beat I drum.
Maya Angelou reminds us, when you know better, you do better. There are many things in need of improvement in our world, many problems that need to be solved. When we continue to ignore these conflicts, they only grow and worsen. It is easy to talk about our goals, aspirations, and for peace and a world full of love, but talking isn't the same as acting. When are we going to do better? When we listen with compassion and learn from one another, we can be part of fixing them, we can do better.
Joined today by vocal activist, conductor, music director, and three-time Grammy-nominated singer-songwriter, Melanie DeMore. Melanie uses her voice as a weapon of mass Melanie uses her voice as a weapon of mass connection and believes in the power of song and voices raised together to heal, to help us understand ourselves, and to understand each other. Please welcome Melanie to the stage.
Hello, fam. First of all, I am blown away by the hope that is our future that's been standing up on the stage. Can we have a little bit of that? And one of the ways we're going to do better is by realizing that we cannot get along without each other. And realizing that song is food and medicine, and you are getting a beautiful dose today. And I have a whole big basket of songs that feed me. And these are hard times, family. Can I just see you nod your head? Can I hear you go, And so we need these songs. And this is a song that was food and nourishment that fed me so long and for days after what happened to our dear brother, George Floyd. This is a song that you all know. And I'll give you a signal where you can join in with me. And it's a song, it's actually a spiritual that comes from the Gullah South Sea Islands of the United States, but most people don't know that. I'll give you an introduction and then we'll go from there. All around our wounded planet, folks are on their knees, looking to their gods and asking, can you help us please? How do we get so far away from the love you gave? What happened to the light and love? Hear us as we pray. Come by here, my Lord. Come by here. Come by here, my Lord. Come by here. Come by here, my Lord. Come by here. Oh, oh Lord, come by here. 'Cause we are weeping alone. Come by here, we are weeping, Lord, come by here.
Harmony is good.
We are weeping, Lord, come by here.
Come by here.
get ready to sing, people. And I'm joined up by my singing family from the Boston Children's Chorus. Come on up, my siblings, my babies, my children. And we're going to be doing the next two or three songs, one song called Hold Everybody Up. Let's practice with you. They already know what to do. So when we say the word hold everybody up, your hands go up. And I'm here from Oakland, California. So we don't just go up, we go up, right? All right. And so you'll see there's clapping, there's all kinds of things. You already know what you're doing. And the world is just much better when all of you raise your voice. Nod your head and go, mm-hmm. All right. Here they come. I'm just gonna stand here and let you look at these beautiful people here. Yes. All right. Oh, I just heard a potential new member of Boston Children's Choir. They start real small. All right, so this is a song called Hold Everybody Up. And now, you know, we get to, well, in a minute. Okay, so you hold everybody up, and that's the idea that even when we feel too scared or weary, there's always a set of hands that are holding us up. We can do it for each other, and when you're just feeling really down, you know, somebody got you. Nod your head. Excellent. Are you ready?
Yes.
Wait, are you ready?
Yes.
Are you ready?
Yes.
You ready?
Yes.
We gotta hold everybody. We gotta hold everybody up. We gotta hold everybody. We gotta hold everybody up. Hold everybody
up, up, up.
Hold everybody up, up, up.
Hold everybody up, up, up.
Hold everybody up. And then we clap. Then we clap. They love that part. Just because you look like you and I look like me, it doesn't mean we can't be friends. You're not my enemy. So we gotta hold everybody. We gotta hold everybody up. We gotta hold everybody. We gotta hold everybody up.
Hold everybody up, up, up. Hold everybody up, up, up. Hold everybody up, up, up. Hold everybody up.
And every clap. Africa, we got it.
Hold everybody.
What?
Got it. Hold everybody up.
We got a hold. And I hope that they take this out there in the world. This song that we all get to, and also in this song you get to bark. That's right, I did say the word bark. This is a civil rights song from the early 60s that was written particularly for youth and kids. And I really love this song, and it's called Dog Dog, and that's not D-O-G, that's D-A-W-G. Now, we'll get to a certain point as it speeds up where you'll get to bark. And when I put my hands up like this, it's the little dog, which sounds like this. Little dog? Big dog? Okay? That was good. Now, I don't have to say this to the young people, but you don't bark until I give you the signal. So let's practice. Little dog. Oh, that was not good. Oh, yes. Big dog. Everybody, let's give them a chance. Hang on, let's see how good they are. Little dog. Really? Little dog. Big dog. Oh, we're ready. So, you see, everybody wants to bark. But the thing is that the words are simple. In one place it goes, if my dog loves your dog, and your dog loves my dog, and my dog loves your dog, and your dog loves my dog, why can't we sit under the apple tree? In other words, if our dogs can get along, what is our problem? You feel me? Excellent. Are we ready?
Yes!
Dog, and. Dog, dog, dig, dog, dig, dog, dog. Dog, dog, dig, dog, dig, dog, dog. Dog, dog, dig, dog, dig, dog, dog. Dog, dog, dig, dog, dig, dog. If my dog loves your dog, and your dog loves my dog, don't rush. And my dog loves your dog, and your dog loves my dog, then why can't we sit under the apple tree? Dog, dog, dig, dog, dig, dog, dog. Dog, dog, dig, dog, dig, dog, dog.
Dog, dog, dig, dog, dig, dog.
Yes.
Dog, dog, dig, dog, dig, dog, dog.
If my dog
loves your dog,
and your dog loves my dog, and my dog loves your dog, and your dog loves my dog, then why can't we sit under the apple tree? Dog, dog, dig, dog, dig, dog, dog. Dog, dog, dig, dog, dig, dog, dog. Dog, dog, dig, dog, dig, dog, dog. Dog, dog, dig, dog,
dig, dog.
If my dog
loves your dog,
and your dog loves my dog, and my dog
loves your dog,
and your dog loves my dog, then why can't we sit under the apple tree? Dog, dog, dig, dog, dig, dog, dog. Dog, dog, dig, dog, dig, dog, dog. Dog, dog, dig, dog. If my dog
loves your dog,
and your dog loves my dog, and my dog loves your dog, and
your dog loves my dog,
then why can't we sit under the
apple
tree? Dog, dog, dig, dog, dig, dog, dog. Dog, dog, dig, dog, dig, dog, dog. Dog, dog, dig, dog, dig, dog. If my dog loves
your dog,
and your dog loves my dog, and my
dog loves your dog, and your dog.
Dog, dog, dig, dog. Dog, dog, dig, dog. Dog, dog, dig, dog. Dog, dog, dig, dog. Dog, dog. If my dog loves your dog,
and your dog loves my dog, and my dog loves your dog, and your dog loves my dog, then why can't we sit under the apple tree?
There you go. All right, this little light of mine, come on.
I'm gonna let it shine.
This little light of mine, I'm gonna let it shine. You know this little light of mine, I'm gonna let it shine.
Let it shine, let it shine, let it shine.
All around the world, all around the world, all around the world, you know. Next piece that they're gonna sing is a song that I wrote called Say, Say Yes. And what I wanted to do was to write a piece where you have a whole bunch of people with an open heart and determination who are moving in your direction. And they're saying, say yes, because there's too much no in the world. So I'm saying, say, say yes. You hold your head up, keep your heart open, and keep moving forward. All right.
Muchísimas gracias por acompañarnos esta tarde. Thank you so much for being with us this afternoon. I don't need to read this part. My name is Andres Holder. I use he, him pronouns, and I'm the executive director for Boston Children's Chorus. Thank you. I still don't get why that gets applause, but I mean, thank you. What a joyous occasion for us to be gathered here this afternoon in the presence of such remarkable talent and boundless energy. Boston Children's Chorus gathers on the unceded homelands of the Wampanoag, Pawtucket, Nipmuc, and Massachusetts tribes who have and continue to steward the land that we live and gather on. Brave. Just saying that word ignites a fire within our souls, doesn't it? Each and every one of these incredible young voices embodies the true spirit of bravery. They've poured their hearts into every note, every melody, and every harmony, infusing this beautiful concert with a courageous sense of joy, belonging, and care. They stand before us not just as performers, but as ambassadors of hope. And we here at BCC are proud to serve as humble advocates for their dreams and aspirations. I want to thank all of you here who support the work of BCC. I see a whole bunch of parents, guardians, siblings who make it possible for all of these young people to show up to rehearsal every single day, every single week, week after week, year after year. So thank you to all of you. And A special thank you for the members of our board of directors and those people who are supporting BCC financially. Thank you so much for being here today. Now, if, and this is an if, I don't take things for granted in this life, if today's performance has moved you as deeply as it has me, I invite you to consider supporting our work financially, supporting these singers, and supporting the mission of BCC with a gift. By making a donation, you are making an investment in these young voices, empowering them to reach new heights, inspiring them to dream without limits. On your programs, in the back, at the top, you'll find a QR code. Scanning it with the camera app on your phone will take you directly to our donation page. Now, together, we can ensure that every single child who sings at BCC, and we sometimes do live at BCC because there's a lot of rehearsal, that you'll help that they find the courage to be brave in pursuing their passions, no matter what obstacles they might face in life. Thank you so much for your generosity, for being here today, and for being part of this incredible journey. It is now my immense pleasure to introduce our music director, Kenneth Griffith.
Thank you all so very much for being here. I'm just coming up on 1 year since I've received this music director position. I feel so very fortunate to have the opportunity to have been here watching these young singers, our youngest singers, our brightest singers, over these last 2 days rehearsing, putting their heart and soul into this program, and getting better with every note, and seeing the commitment that they just is dripping from them in every bit of their performance. It really makes me feel proud to be in this position, and thankful for all of the staff, all of the conductors, the band here who helped to support, and you, of course, who helped to support them in getting here and making this possible. I wanted to take an opportunity to introduce our next song. Since 2019, Boston Children's Chorus has been developing an exciting commissioning project sponsored by the TD Charitable Foundation, Opus Nuovo, with the goal of creating new choral works representative of our community and championing the works of composers outside of the Eurocentric Western canon. Today's concert features the premiere of a brand new work by Melanie DeMore. And it's entitled Stand Up. She works collaboratively with our singers from the Roxbury Intermediate Advanced Ensemble. Give me a wave. She works with them collaboratively to create the text and the spirit of this piece. Melanie, we're so grateful for you and the gift that you've given us with this piece and the gift that we're about to share with the world. So without further ado, we introduced to you Stand Up. And we welcome Crystal Moore and back to the stage to conduct.
Stand up, stand up, rise up, stand up, rise up, stand 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 up, st
If you need a world to belong to, look around, you're already home. And what you seek, you've already found. Turn around to me, you will see no reason to be lonely.
Never doubt the power you have to help another.
Our words and actions can inspire, heal, and transform. Turn around to me, and when you doubt yourself, I will be there to remind you that you are loved, you are enough, and you are not alone.
Many of us needed people who believed in us before we could believe in ourselves. The choice to celebrate another person and help them see their unique beauty can create a positive ripple effect that transforms our world to be more colorful, vibrant, and welcoming for all.
You with the sad eyes, don't be discouraged, oh, I realize it's hard to take courage in a world full of people. You can lose sight of it all, the darkness inside you can make you feel so small.
She
Show me a smile then. Don't be unhappy, can't remember when I last saw you laughing. This world makes you crazy, and you've taken all you can bear. Just call me up, 'cause I will always be there. Taking all you can bear, just call me up, 'cause I will always be there.
Last time you truly felt brave? Writer and activist Audre Lorde once said, "When we speak, we are afraid our words will not be heard or welcomed. But when we are silent, we are still afraid. So it is better to speak." In life, being completely self-confident and sure of what you want to say seems extremely rare, and this world pressures us to be anything but brave. However, as Audre Lorde suggests, it is better to dare to be powerful than to hide in fear of being rejected or misunderstood. We can choose to face what scares us so that we can stand tall and be brave not only for ourselves, but for each other.
You can be amazing, you can turn a phrase into a put down or a hug.
one more, shall we? This song is called Lead With Love. You'll get it. All right. Are we ready?
Yes!
Are we ready?
Yes!
Stay with me, baby. Stay with me. There we go. You gotta put one foot in front of the other and lead with love. Put one foot in front of the other and lead with love. You gotta put one foot in front of the other and lead with love. Put one foot in front of the other and
Come on,
come on!
All right, everybody. Thank you so much for being here with us at Brave. We have some important announcements just to make sure that if you are looking to pick up your singer, you know where to find them, and we can do so smoothly and safely. If you are a guardian of a training choir singer, please stay put here in the sanctuary. They're going to go grab their belongings upstairs and come right back here. So, Jamaica Plain Training with Miss I and South End Training 1 with me are going to be on this side of the house. Dorchester Advanced Training with Mr. Reynolds will be on the stage. South End Training 2 with Miss Hooven. East Boston Training with Miss Cooper will be on this side of the house. If you're an intermediate choir parent, they are going to go grab their stuff across the hall in the chapel, Gordon Chapel, and you can go meet them there to check them out. If you don't have a singer to collect, we do ask that you kindly take your conversations outside. Tell everybody how much you loved our experience, and that will help us make a smooth checkout. Thank you very much, and we look forward to seeing you again.